You and Biggie got married, shortly after you guys met. Is that correct?
Yeah, we actually got married. Now, so I can make sure I continue to correct it, which I've always done. But people tend to say 7 days. I don't know who made that up, but we actually got married more like 2 months, maybe a little less than 2 months after we started hanging out and talking. But it definitely wasn't 7 days. Now, I'm not saying that 2 months is, a nice courting period before you marry someone, but it wasn't a week. It was probably like 6, 7 weeks, something like that.
What made you guys decide that, that you guys should get married as opposed to, continue to date?
Well, we were young. We definitely, had a very quick, we definitely fell in love very quickly. But we were moving fast because we were young and we weren't thinking it out like that, We didn't know he was about to blow up like that and that my record was gonna do well. We were both signed as artists, but neither one of us had necessarily, seen success yet. So we just weren't thinking and moving fast, and we knew we were in love. And he said, "I want to marry you." And I said, "When?" He said, "We could do it now." And I said, "Well, let me ask my friend who just got married upstate New York." He said it didn't take much. So within a week or two after he said that, we were married, but that wasn't when we met. So, maybe that's where that story came from, the 7 days. But yeah, I mean, he told me he wanted to marry me after a couple of weeks of us hanging out, So it seemed like a great thing to do. I mean, I'm not mad I did. He's certainly the first true, my first true, love of my life. So I'm not mad at it.
You both had daughters at the time as well. Do you think that
Yes.
was part of the connection?
Maybe so. And I think I can definitely say I was attracted to his, first of all, sense of humor. That was the first thing that even caught my attention about him, aside from his confidence, because I didn't know this guy. We met at a photo shoot, and it was just him, myself, and Craig Mack and Puff there. And I think we were waiting for total for to see if they were coming. I don't know, but by the time we started shooting, he had struck up conversation. He saw me looking at some photos I had just got developed, and it was like maybe my daughter's birthday party, I think. And he asked, he had jotted my number down and I didn't know it off the little envelope from the photo place. So by the time we left the photo shoot and he asked me, could I drop his friends off, him and the guys off to Brooklyn, he had already taken my phone number. So I didn't know that until he got out the car. And I think also he was a little intrigued by the fact that he saw me at this photo shoot with Hurricane G, who at the time was down with the hit squad, Eric Sermon's daughter's mom. She was a good friend of mine, and she had come with me to this photo shoot. So he probably was like, "Well, now how does she know her?" Because he knew Gloria from Brooklyn, but I'm from Jersey, a church girl. You know what I mean? So he was probably trying to figure out my connection as well. But before, the industry, Redman and I, were really cool. So I knew Red already. So that's how I knew Gloria. So Big was probably like, "Dang, she knows her way around Brooklyn. She knows her." So he just was striking up conversation, and I think he was probably attracted to the fact that I kind of, from what it seemed to him, obviously had something going on for myself. Like, even aside from being assigned artist to Bad Boy, he said he used to see me at the studio, but he thought I was somebody's, a session singer or something. But all that time, I was, writing songs. Puff had me working on Mary's My Life album, Usher's first album, and a few other projects before my first album started being recorded. So, he kind of saw that I had a little hustle and grind in me and had my little car, and we were cracking jokes the whole way to Brooklyn. So when I dropped him off, he told me he was going to call me, and I didn't, like, I ain't give him my number, but he called me later on that day. So he had taken my number. So I thought that was pretty cute, and that kind of like was flattering and attractive. So we just started talking, and I started going to Brooklyn, and every day it would be, "Oh, what are we going to eat today?" Or, That's pretty much how our thing started.
I read through your book, and one of the stories that kind of stood out to me was you had found a Polaroid of a girl in Biggie's car, and you managed to look up her phone number and find out where her address is, and you went to this girl's apartment and beat her up.
Well, I didn't. Okay. Okay, yeah, there's this layers is, to that story.
This is
yeah,
not
that's
hearsay.
True.
This is from your book.
Yeah, right? That's very true. But the funny thing is, which I also said that we left from Puff's son's Justin's christening and jumped in a cab to go to this girl's house. Oh boy! But yeah, that was my wild and crazy days. Yeah, that's very true. But it wasn't by myself, and I didn't like go and put the schmurt on the girl or nothing. I actually had some accomplices, and we didn't probably even really hit her that much. I think it was just the whole scaring. That was just out of line. I ain't about to sit here and say that was cool to do at all. I mean, I know that was so out of line. I've done so many, especially in that few year period right there with this guy Big. I definitely did some things that I'm like, what was I thinking? Like, with, some near-death situations. Like, somebody could have done anything to me. What was I doing? I was just a little too bold, a little too bold when it came to that man in my heart. But, you live and you learn. And thank God I knew then it was wrong. I knew that it was something that I would certainly have to, deal with karma. I think knowing that and embracing it and getting past it and knowing that I would never do most of those things again, but yeah, that was pretty crazy. But I just wanted to show him because he used to do stuff like that to me and my platonic friends or just because. So, it was kind of a tit for tat type of thing.
Oh, so Biggie beat up some of your male friends?
Well, he didn't, but he actually one time, which is also in my book, one of my friends that I knew from church, and he lived in our neighborhood when we finally got our apartment in Brooklyn. He knew I knew a lot of people from church over there, but I think we had an argument about something else. And this one day I was going to pick my daughter up from the babysitter in Brooklyn around the corner from me and Big's place. And my friend from church who hadn't seen me since China was born, he saw us and he was like, "Oh my God, let me see the baby." Da, da, da. So we're just outside of the babysitter's building talking, and he's holding China, and Big drives by with his homeboys, and just because we were already kind of pissed with each other, we had an argument probably before I left the house. I don't even know what it was about, but he just like pulled up. He asked the dude, "Could he hold, like, let me see China?" He didn't say many words at all, and then before I knew it, his friends jumped out the car and started beating my friend up in the middle of the street in Brooklyn. I was so embarrassed. And I felt horrible because, I know Big didn't do it because he thought there was something going on with me and the guy. He just did it because, I was really mad. I was so mad at that and embarrassed again, like I said, because I'm like, oh, my God, this is crazy. I do not need the church to be talking about this. But, I actually helped him. I took him back to our apartment so he could get a towel and stuff because he was bleeding and everything. And I just felt bad, and I just said, I just apologized profusely to him, and that was it. That's probably the last time I saw him. Crazy
in the book,
time.
You also talked about the situation where you actually walked in on Big in a hotel room and he had a girl there and you beat the girl up that time.
That time I definitely did lay hands. I did. And I didn't walk in. I didn't, she opened the door. So I just immediately started hitting her because I already knew something was up because, he gave himself away by calling me to tell me I'm not going to be in my room. I'm letting such and such. Like, come on, kid. Good and well, that does not sound convincing. Like, what are you? And I'm in another state. So, of course, I had to call my homegirl and ask her to watch my daughter. I had it all mapped out. I'm like, it's a 6 a.m. flight going to Virginia Beach. Take me 45 minutes to get there. They ain't going to be awake and checking out. I had it all mapped out. And I got there, got all that done, came back on the next flight, and all of that before 10 a.m. I was back in Brooklyn by 10 a.m. By 12 noon, Big was back in Brooklyn looking for me, too.
How badly did the girl get beat up?
I don't know, because I didn't really stop. I didn't stop for a second. I just was going in and looking at him every once in a while. I look at him, and he's just sitting on the bed shaking his head. That's when he was like, "I didn't even fuck her." That's why I was like, "You should have." That is all very, very, very true. Like, I remember that as clear as day. And by the time I was done hitting her, all the guys had come. He done called everybody from their room C's and L, whoever else was out of town with him, all just standing there looking at me. But I was putting my coat on to leave by then. I was like, bye, y'all. I'm done.
So you basically left her in the room bleeding.
I sure did. I know what it was. One of her homegirl must have been in the room with one of the guys. So by then her friend came, but I'm already on my way to the elevator. It was nothing they could do. They wasn't going to do nothing to me.